In the energy quadrant today, looking at WTI crude oil, the July contract traded at the CME Group, we had a 4% move on the highs. It was a technical breakout the way that it traded. That 4% move took us up to 36.89 on the high side of things. That's the highest level since early March for WTI crude oil, breaking through those mid-April highs that we saw on the rotation back up. That got up to about 35 and change. And again, this is a technical breakout because it entered into that gap lower that we saw in late April, early March. That would take us up to 40 if that were to actually fill. A lot of technicians looking at that, hence the strength in the closing at the highs today was probably technical. But also associated with that, there was talk and reporting that OPEC Plus has agreed to extend their production cut. Now, this is not fact yet. This is what their conversations have been. The only reporting that I saw of an actual quote was of the Iraqi finance minister who said Iraq is not prepared to give up on these production cuts just yet, despite their poor finances. That shows a commitment, and Iraq is the second largest producer within OPEC after Saudi Arabia. Pretty strong endorsement that they might have an extension to the production cut, at least within OPEC. Not hearing anything out of Russia specifically yet, who is the largest producer in the plus part of OPEC Plus. And lastly, we're looking at EIA tomorrow, but looking specifically at refinery utilization. The refinery utilization number has been below 75 of the last 7 weeks. That's unprecedented, going all the way back to 1990. And it could be that we actually have over capacity or too much capacity in refining now. And that could have an effect on prices no one's really seeing, because that's something the U.S. hasn't experienced in quite some time.